स्टैंडर्ड थर्ड, सब्जेक्ट ग्रामर, चैप्टर फोर, पार्ट थ्री. टॉपिक इज नंबर्स एंड अवर टुडे सब टॉपिक इज काउंटेबल नाउंस एंड अनकाउंटेबल नाउंस. हेलो चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? एवरी डे डूइंग वीडियो वर्क, वर्कशीट वर्क, सो यू आर सो बिजी, राइट? एज वेल एज यू हैव टू प्ले ऑल्सो. प्ले वे मैथड यू कैन लर्न बाई वीडियोज. That's why we all are sending you some videos for learning. Okay, so you have to sit with your parents and you have to see the all the videos, listen it carefully and try to write your answers. Now today my topic is countable and uncountable nouns. Okay, let's learn by some examples. First with the definition. Countable nouns have plural forms. Whenever we are thinking this we can count, so it will be in singular form. No, you can count by the numbers also. For example, one spoon, two spoons, one student, two students, right? All can countable. If there is one, then also we can count. And if there is more than one, then also we can count in singular form, in plural forms. Both we can count. Countable nouns are objects that can be counted as separate units using numbers. Whenever we want to count something, first of all, we have to use the numbers to count it. Right? For example, 1, 2, 2 spoons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 students. We use number to count them, right? One table in singular form, one table. But in countable plural form, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 tables. There is one fridge in the room. You can see how many fridge in the room? There is only one fridge in the room. So you can count. There are four chairs. 1, 2, 3, and 4. There are four chairs in the room. There are two lamps on the wall. You can see how many lamps on the wall? 1 and 2. So there are two lamps on the wall. Now uncountable nouns do not have plural forms because you can't count uncountable nouns with the numbers. Uncountable nouns are objects that cannot be separated and counted individually. Means 1, 2, 3, 4, like that way you can't count uncountable nouns. Okay, you cannot make it, or you cannot be separated and counted individually. You count them individually. Let me explain you by some examples. We use quantifiable words such as much, some, or a little before uncountable nouns to quantify them. If you want to count those things, so which words you have to put before nouns? Much, some, or little. See downside some examples. Much snow. You can count snow? No, it is not possible. Some floor. You can count floor? No, you can't count floor. A little jam. You can count jam? No. You have to say a little jam. If you want jam, so you have to say give me more jam, give me so much jam, give me a little jam. Like that way you have to show the quantity. You can't count with the number. You can't say 2 snow, 4 floor, 3 jam. You can't say like this way. You can't use number. You can use quantifiable words before nouns. See, there is some water in the jug. This is also uncountable. You can't count the drop of the water, right? You can say, give me some water. Give me lots of water because I am very thirsty. So you can use this kind of plural form between before nouns. Okay? A glass of water. Okay? So like that way you can measure the word with the water, means water is uncountable noun. So you can measure word glass. Some luggage, some paper, some furniture. Give me some cheese, please. Means you can't count the cheese. That is uncountable. So you can use some or more. Okay. Give me more cheese. Okay. If you like cheese more, so you can say, give me more cheese. So like that way you can write uncountable noun. Two pieces of furniture. You can't measure this word of furniture. So that's why that is uncountable noun. Furniture is uncountable. So you can use pieces word for furniture. A box of cereal means you can't count cereal. That is uncountable noun. So you have to use measure word box. Two bars of soap. That is, soap is also uncountable noun. So you can measure soap word by use bars. Now see some abstract nouns. Abstract nouns are mostly uncountable. You can't count your feelings, right? You can't count your happiness, okay? Your sadness, your laziness, your courage for your country, your patriotism. You can't count these all because these all are your emotions, your feelings. You can't count. You can count your happiness. You can count your sadness? No. Okay, if you are happy, so you can say, I am so much happy today. But you can't count your happiness with a number because that is abstract noun, that is uncountable noun. You can't count your feelings. Okay, so students, I think so. You got this countable and uncountable concept very easily with the examples. Okay. So you learn and learn again and again this video, then and then you can recognize and then you can understand easily which are countable nouns and which are uncountable nouns and how you can measure uncountable noun. Till then, stay safe, Jai Hind and goodbye.